Good evening. Thank you so much for being here tonight. My name is Stephen Atisio. I'm the director and chief curator of the Blaffer Art Museum, and I want to welcome all of you to the fifth episode of A Time for Action, an interdisciplinary performance festival. Tonight's program is curated by Rivkah French, and so I have the pleasure and honor of giving a quick biographical introduction to Rivkah. But before that, I just want to add a few housekeeping notes and a few thank yous. So first of all, we are encouraging all of our guests to wear masks, but you will notice that our performers will be allowed to be unmasked. This entire program is presented by the Blaffer Art Museum and sponsored by the Cynthia Woods Mitchell Center for the Arts. And so I want to give a huge thanks to Melissa Noble and everyone at the Mitchell Center for both their support and their assistance. I also want to give a massive thanks to everyone at the Blaffer Art Museum, especially Blanca, Colleen, Amanda, Skylar, Tyler, everyone that has worked so tirelessly behind the scenes to make sure these performances go off so smoothly, as well as all of our students who work with us and are so kind and helpful. Please give them a huge round of applause. And speaking of students, we have two wonderfully talented and very dedicated theater students, Chrissy and Desiree, who are operating as our stage managers. Both of them have done a wonderful job. And we're also working with Karen Martinez, who is video documenting all of the programs so that they will be available in a few weeks' time on our YouTube channel. Those are the credits that I want to give. And now I want to give thanks and introduce Rivkah French. Rivkah is a Houston-based choreographer, a performance artist, and community leader with over 25 years of experience in the field and who has curated over 30 performance programs as well as multimedia exhibitions. One of them, almost 2 years to the day that Rivkah mentions in the program, was Uprising, a night of dance commemorating the anniversary of the Stonewall Rebellion, the 50th anniversary at the Contemporary Arts Museum, Houston, which was wonderfully successful and actually the first time that I saw Rivkah's work in person. Since then, Rivkah has worked, I just want to note a few things, has founded and directed the nonprofit dance theater Freneticore, built and managed the organization's Black Box theatrical venue, founded and produced the Houston Fringe Festival, and has taught movement arts to at-risk children and adults, as well as the homeless and incarcerated teens. Rivkah works now in work that fosters healing and empowerment through self-expression for the LGBTQ+ community and expands the field of queer dance theory and everything that they do. Please give a big round of applause to all the performers and to Rivkah, and I hope that you enjoy.
Drag performance began as a way for gay folks to explore gender through music, costumes, makeup, and movement in safe spaces that celebrated queer expression and community. It's played an important part in every LGBTQ+ rights movement, and drag performers have always been at the helm of positive social change. A genre that was once illegal in the US is now a popular and extremely diverse field of gender-bending art that includes drag kings, queens, and in-betweens, or genderqueer and non-binary performers. Experimental drag can be expressed through exaggerated makeup, props, and costuming resembling dangerous or glamorous monsters, aliens, or even abstract art.
Thank you.
queer dance theory defined. 1. Women and feminism are central to any queer project. 2. Social dance and concert dance hold equal import. 3. Through anti-racist and anti-colonial labor, queerness must always work to challenge white supremacy. 4. Queer dance happens across an expansive map, both global and regional. 5. Queerness must challenge the entrenchment of the gender binary.
The 14th century. These were then popularized with a series of decks commissioned by the Visconti Sforza, Dukes of Milan, circa 1450. From that aristocratic court, the cards were taken to France, to England, and to other kingdoms in Europe. The cards used the basic deck brought into Europe from the Mamluk of Egypt around 1367. Which are also the origin of today's poker and bridge decks. An extra set of cards, the 22 triumphs, or major arcana, were added to the basic cards to create a quote-unquote trump-taking game called Taroki, somewhat akin to today's bridge. Furthermore, the court cards that correspond to our basic four playing card suits are joined by a fourth household member. In most decks, the royal family are portrayed as king, queen, knight, and page.
Hi, everybody. I am Shannon.
And I am a tarot and a medium. I've been doing this for about 30 years now. I had a near-death experience back in the 90s when it wasn't cool, or when it was cool. And ever since then, I've been able to read and read people and read the cards. So I'm looking for one volunteer, anybody that would like to come up on stage and get their cards read. Come on. So, as she's coming up, I want to share, can I get your name?
Yes,
Seema. Okay, Seema, I want you to come and pull a card. I'll say thank you. And then you pull a card. I'm going to tell you right now, you have about three guys that are with you that walk with you all the time, and they really, really guard you a lot. So choose any one of the cards, and we'll see what spirit has to say for you. And you have quite a few people on the other side, your family members that are there with you. So you got the Four of Cups. And the Four of Cups represent, like, there's a lot of things that are in front of you, but you don't know which ones you want to choose. And so any of them that you choose is going to be the Bible. Okay? Even if it's career-wise, if you're working, okay. I think you have a better opportunity right now that if you want to get promoted, it's great. I would go into that. I would put my promotion in there. They're really talking about it. They're really, really loud about it. And that really indicates that it's yours. If you want, I would take it. Any personal, any other questions? Because you have four of them.
And grandmother.
Okay.
Or great grandmother. I also have a great grandmother.
You have four that's there. There are four of your ancestors that are on the other side.
Okay.
With the four.
Right.
The four
right.
Of cups.
Okay, I'll pick another.
Yes, you can. And they really want you to. You really need to come out your shell a little bit more. You've been really reserved. And they're really wanting you to come out a little more. Yeah. They want you to really come out and start really playing full out because the opportunities are there for you, but you just need to make that happen. Absolutely. Good night. Yes. And that's beautiful because that means the Knight of Swords is the one that's like, he comes in and rescues you. He comes in and takes you away and takes you where you need to go. It's the defender. You wish you off your feet in that space. But in this instance, it's saying whatever you do is going to do. It's going to go. You're going to go really, really fast. Yes, very fast.
Very fast.
And money is going to come really, really fast. Man, money. I see lots of money. Yes.
Let's pick another card.
One more. Yeah, that happens when the spirit's around, and I'll ask them to back out of energy for you. That happens. And breathe and let it go. Choose one more. This is the King of Pentacles, and the King of Pentacles has all kinds of things around him, and all these gifts that are for you, and you just have to choose them. You're the ruler of this. How do you want to manifest it? How do you want to bring it in? And your grandmother, Agnes, she's the one that's been with me most of the day talking. Awesome. I had work in today. She really puts that energy in, wanting to play full out with you, really guides you, really push you. And if you just let and keep walking forward, there's nothing that's up. Awesome. Thank you so much for allowing me in your energy, and thank your ancestors for allowing me there. Thank you. Thank you all. I'll be back.
problem. If finding somebody real is your fucking problem, bring your girls to the crib, maybe we can solve. Hold up, bitch, it's summertime. Taking hella long, bitch, give it to me now. Make that thing pop like it's semi-urbanine. Ooh, baby, like it raw with the shimmy, shimmy, yeah, huh? ASAP, get like me. Never met a motherfucker fresh like me. All these motherfuckers wanna dress like me. But the chrome to your dome, make you sweat like me.
Thank you. until I comprehend a word black eyes. Every so slowly, my tongue clears. I cannot claim that I know running out. Until I comprehend a small pebble rolling ever so quickly off the steep, ever so slowly, I cannot claim I know. I cannot claim that I know. Until I comprehend a small pebble rolling ever so quickly off the steep, I cannot claim that I know. I cannot claim I know. Until I comprehend a small pebble rolling ever so quickly off a steep cliff, I cannot claim I know standing rock.
It's over, the lovers trying to take their breath away. It's all for the gain. It's all for the lovers trying to chase the rush again. It's all for the gain. It's all for the lovers trying to take their breath away. It's all for the gain. It's all for the lovers trying to chase the rush again. But I'm never gonna give up. Did you want me all? No, not for life. Did you truly see me? No, not this time. Were you ever sure? No, 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 not with me. That's why it's all for the gain. It's all for the lovers trying to push the pain away.
Get a reading? Come on. Don't be shy. So tell me your name.
Charles.
Say it again?
Charles.
Awesome, Charles. All right. Go ahead and choose a card. Ten of Pentacles. The Ten of Pentacles really defines, and you've got all, you've got the world, you've got everything with you, you have loyalty, you have people that are around you that will help you and show up for you and be there for you. But sometimes you forget. You forget there are people that want to support you and help you. And what I want to attend shows up and says, hey, let them support you. Let them show up for you. Because you're always, you have such a big heart and you show up and help them, but they need to show up and help you now. And it's okay for that. And do you work? Here we go. And what are you doing? Awesome. Yes. And yet again, my friend, you have a lot of things that's really coming your way. You just need to implement and get a little bit more help. And you have, if you look to you by your own self, you own your own business, I would start a business. I want to tell you right now, I would start a business. You have it. You just need to find somebody to help you a little bit. And there's enough, I don't know if you need capital, but you have enough gifts and stuff that's happening, Spirit's going to just guide it right through. And there's somebody that wants to help you with that. But a business, you have an idea, you already have an idea for it. Any other questions? Awesome. Anybody else want to? Thank you, Charles.
Right here.
Thank you. Come on. Thank you so much. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.